Is my screen presenting to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
So, I had changed some slides and added some more slides so that you can get comfortable to read and understand about all the things, okay? So first of all, in our syllabus, there are only Jnana Sapta Bhumika. So I clear out Ajnana Bhumika, okay? Because this not related with our syllabus. So you are also getting confused in their names or learning. So that's why I cleared out, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
I added slide like Yoga Vasishtha consists 32,000 verses. There is no doubt in this. Log after that, Laghu Yoga Vasishtha is also written. Laghu, not by Valmiki, by some other text, other writer.
In this,
Laghu Yoga Vasishtha with 6,000 verses, okay? And one more thing is Laghu Tara Yoga Vasishtha, Laghu Tara Yoga Vasishtha with 1,000 verses. This is also important because these are also contained very less verses with great knowledge, okay? With all knowledge of Yoga Vasishtha. So it means these are good and will have to remember their name. After it, Pujya Swami Tejomayananda ji also written Yoga Vasishtha Sar Sangraha. Yoga Vasishtha Sar Sangraha with 86 verses in his book. Okay, so he compiled all the Yoga Vasishtha. I don't know how he is compiled. Maybe he took only important slokas or I don't know, but this is important. Okay. So Laghu Yoga Vasishtha 6,000 verses by Abhinandan Gaur, Laghu Tara Yoga Vasishtha with 1,000 verses, and Yoga Vasishtha Sar Sangraha by Pujya Swami Tejomayananda ji with 86 verses. Okay. Shall we move further?
Excuse me, ma'am. Ma'am, can you show me previous slide? One second. I was not previous. Not this one, maybe. Before slide.
This one?
No. What you are showing now, na? Just before that. Means where written?
Yes. Syllabus you are saying, Lipalika.
Okay.
I think she is saying the Laghu Yoga Vasishtha with 1,000 verses and all these things were written in that slide.
Yes. Means there is written also Jnana Sapta Bhumika, I think. Because I have network issue, that's why I could not see on that time.
Here is mentioned Laghu Yoga Vasishtha written by Abhinandan Gaur. This line?
So I have. This one also I have. Another one slide. Okay, ma'am.
Syllabus, if I'm not wrong, it's a syllabus that you showed.
Okay. This one, ma'am. Yes. This one, syllabus, yes. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Next is... this Jnana Sapta Bhumika is also known as seven stages of spiritual unfoldment. Okay, seven stages of spiritual unfoldment. Okay. So this is I added and cleared out a Jnana Bhumika and added Jivan Mukta. Added Jivan Mukta. So it means.
Ma'am, What did you say?
Yes.
Jnana Sapta Bhumika was something you said previous slide, ma'am. Can I note that, please? Yeah.
Seven stages of spiritual unfoldment.
Okay.
Yes, Deepam ji.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, please divide all seven stages of spiritual unfoldment.
Okay. The first one is Shubhecha. Basically, this is a term derived with two words.
Just names only.
Okay. Shubhecha, Vicharana, Tanu Mansa. Then we have Asang Sakti, right? Just a second. I've noted it down.
I'm asking you because
yeah.
I think you are lovely.
Yes, ma'am. Practice thoda chal raha hai. Tanu Mansa, then we have Satvapatti, then Asang Sakti, Padartha Bhavani, and last is Turiyaga.
Very good. Okay. So, at the time of Subhecha, at the time of practicing Subhecha, the seeker or the sadhak is still a seeker, remains a seeker, okay? At the time of Vicharana, at the stage of Vicharana, the sadhak is also remain a seeker. And at the time of Tanu Mansa, it is also same, okay? Still a seeker. Okay, means there is showing the level of sadhaka, stage of sadhaka, where it is. Okay, means sadhaka, if they want to get moksha, salvation, okay, so they are confusing what are the path, we feel that we are progressing. Okay, so this is the chart for understanding that where we are now. Okay, so at the time of Subhecha, Vicharana, and Tanu Mansa, the sadhaka, seeker, remain a seeker. Okay, like we are studying in school, in college. At that time, always we are a student. Okay, after becoming a teacher, then position is clear out. Okay, then after that we are not student, we are a teacher. Okay, so same as in Subhecha, Vicharana, Tanu Mansa, the sadhaka remains a seeker, means they are practicing or moving on the path. Okay, not are getting something big position. Clear? Yes, Nepalika,
yes.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. So Satvapatti. In Satvapatti, sadhaka remains Brahmavit. What remains? Brahmavit. Now, what do you mean by Brahmavit? Brahmavit means knower of Brahma. Who is know the Brahma? Jan Chukai. Who had know about the Brahma, who is Brahma. Because of self-knowledge, he, sadhaka, remains untouched and unaffected by all desires. It is the meaning of Brahmavit. You can also write down right now. Brahmavit means remain untouched. And unaffected by all desires because of self-knowledge. This is known as
what makes such knowledge?
Because of self-knowledge, because of Tattva Gyan, right knowledge.
Okay.
Self-knowledge. Okay, so this is Brahmavit, knower of Brahma. Tattvapatti, real knowledge. know the real self. You had also studied in Yoga Darshan, the third or fourth sutra. Like if we are practicing Abhyas Vairagya, then we get the real knowledge of us. Like we can differentiate between body and Atma. Okay. Am I right?
Are you saying that Tada Drashtuhu Swarupe Avasthanam?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Tada Drashtuhu Swarupe Avasthanam. We are getting the real self. What are the real self of us? We are the Atma, not the body. The body is different, and body is like temporary, okay, you know this point. Okay, so shall we move further? Asam Sakti happens in sleep, okay, so Shubhta Avastha, and it's Jivan Mukta, Sadhak. Jivan Mukta means the level or the stage of Sadhaka is Brahma Vidvara. Brahma Vidvara. What is it? Brahma Vidvara. Brahma Vidvara means superior knower of Brahma. Superior knower of. Here is knower of Brahma. Knower of Brahma. And it is superior knower of Brahma. Okay. How it is? By absence of mind. By absence of man, because here in Tanu Mansa we are getting ended up all the vrittis which are starting lifting up in man. Okay, so because of absence of mind, here we get the level of Brahma Vidvara, a superior knower of Brahma. Okay. Shall we move?
Yes, ma'am.
Next is Padartha Abhavani. Abhavani. Padartha Abhavani, which is happen in Turiya state, deep sleep. Okay. And here the positions, the level of Sadhaka is Brahma Vidvariyan. Brahma Vidvariyan. Brahma Vidvariyan. It means higher than Brahma Vidvara. Okay, it is Brahma Vidvara, and it is higher than Brahma Vidvara. Means more higher stage. Like we study in Yoga Darshan, types of Samadhi, Savikalpa Samadhi, Nirvikalpa Samadhi, Savichar and Nirvichar. Okay, so then comes Ritambara Pragya or more, okay, these are the stages. Like first is Savikalp Samadhi, okay. So same is Brahma Vidvara is superior knower of Brahma. Brahma Vidvaryan is the higher than Brahma Vidvara. More concentrated or more focused, we can say, to Brahma. Okay. And after that, last is Turiyaga, which is the state is Turiyatit, means deep to deep sleep. Means this is the level of Samadhi. Okay, Sunya. We are different, remain different from body. Okay, so this state is Brahma Vidvarishtha. Brahma Vidvarishtha, the last one. It means the seeker or one who has reached this pinnacle of Samadhi. Means he is reached at the level of Samadhi, merged with God. Okay, the last stage of Sadhaka. Means whoever is many of sannyasi, maharshi practicing of getting Samadhi. So at the last stage of Samadhi, after getting Samadhi, it means the stage of Brahma Vidvarishtha, merged with God or raised at the level of Samadhi. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear out. So you had to learn most important thing. This is Jivan Mukta stages. Okay. Brahma Vid, Brahma Vidvara, Brahma Vidvaryan, Brahma Vidvarishtha, Yoga Vasishtha. Brahma Vidvarishtha. Okay. Shall we move? Anyone have doubt?
No one.
Okay. And also, if you want to read more than want to read more in these, okay. So I can also send you a PDF. Okay. So you can read more about these. I can clear out in a short form. Okay, till now. Shall we move? Okay, I also added this one slide. This is you had learned about this, but okay, we can revise once more. So Subhechha means auspicious resolve, auspicious desire. Okay, Ichha, auspicious good desire, good resolve. Vicharana means reflection, like reflection. Tanumansa, attenuation, thinness of mind, thinness of mind, lack of mind, means lack of vrittis in mind. Tattvapatti, attainment of real self. It also means we are moving at the stage of niravikalpa samadhi. This is important.
Ma'am, can you wait for a while, ma'am? Ma'am, can you, sorry to interrupt you, your screen is not showing. Can you wait for a while, please?
Okay, my screen is not visible.
Yeah, so. Yeah. Is it for others also?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it not visible?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am. So what you're explaining, we won't understand. It will come back in a while, ma'am. Please wait.
Okay, okay, no problem.
Ma'am, are you sharing?
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I'm sharing from my phone. Okay, just Deepam ji, please revise the all Jivan Mukta with all Gyan Bhumika.
Okay. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, you are.
Yeah, so we have seven Gyan Bhumikas. And here the first one is Shubhecha. So the very thing is Shubhecha, we do it from ourselves. So that is why we are still a seeker, right? We are trying to become Jivan Mukta. So we are doing it from ourselves and we are doing it as a seeker. Then comes Vicharna, same as the first one. Then we have Tanu Manasa. After from Sattva Patti onwards, we start to feel the changes. We become Brahmavit. Then from Asansakti, we become Brahma Vidvara. At Padartha Bhavni, we are a Brahma Vidvarian. And the last stage, Turiyaga, we become Brahma Vidvarishtha.
Yes, Lipalika ji.
Revise this few more times actually.
Yes, Lipalika ji. Please revise all commentaries on Yoga Vashishtha.
Okay, ma'am. Vasishtha Ramayana written by Vasishtha Ramayana Chandrika by Adharayana Narahari Shan, and then Tatparaya Prakasa written by Ananda Vadhendra Saraswati, then Bhashya by Gangadharendra, and Pada Chandrika by Madhav Saraswati, Yog Vasishtha Hrudayama by Kupa Venkata Krishnamurti, and Yog Vasishtha Ratnakaram by Swami Vidya Prakashananda Giri.
Okay. And what about the Lagu Yoga, Lagu Vasishtha Sar Sangraha?
Lagu Vasishtha Sar Sangha written by Abhinandan Gowda, and total.
Okay, really?
Lagu Vasishtha.
Okay. Okay, one second. Yes, Sakshi ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Facing bit of network issue, that's why I was not responding. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Please clear out last point.
Just a second, ma'am. What is happening? Yes, ma'am. What you said? Sorry, ma'am, can you repeat?
Yog Vasishtha Sar Sangraha is written by?
Oh, acha, writer name. Yog Vasishtha Sar Sangraha. I'm not able to recall. Is it, ma'am, Bhashya? Ma'am, Bhashya?
I have to teach you today.
Ma'am, Swami Tejo Mayananda, something you told.
Yes.
Ma'am, so much of commentaries, so little confusing.
No problem, but you will have to learn.
Yes, ma'am. No
slowly, okay, learn, but focus on learning.
Ma'am, this slide today only you added, na?
I added only two or three slides.
Okay.
Just see. Okay. Yes. Now it's done. Come back. Okay, so let's get started. Is my screen not visible?
Not yet, ma'am.
Okay, is my screen visible?
No, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. This is we have covered till now Gyana Bhumika, okay? So these are the next slide. Satvapatti means attainment of real, and it means we are moving at the Nirvikalpa Samadhi, okay? We are just moving. Asam Sakti attained by a repeated practice of Nirvikalpa Samadhi. It is same like Dharana, Dharana and Dhyana, okay? Dharana and Dhyana. Here is we are practicing, we are moving at the Nirvikalpa Samadhi, and it is by a repeated practice of Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Desirelessness, all desires are moving away, okay? And all are same. Padartha Bhavya. We are moving slow. So far from the world. Okay, clear out.
Ma'am, can you explain this once again? Couldn't understand.
Is happening. I think my slide is not the right slide.
Right now it was showing the all Gyan Bhumikas.
Now my friend is presenting. Tarun.
Yes, ma'am.
Is my friend presenting? Okay. So this is okay. You had covered this point. Satvapatti means we are moving at the Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Asamsakti means regular practice of, repeated practice of Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Same like Dharana, Dhyan. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And Padartha Abhavni, objectlessness, all elements are, or we are far from this temporary world. Abhav of lack of every element. Turyaga means no return to the awareness of world. Okay. We also studied Adi Vyadi, type of disease, Vyadi and Adi. Vyadi is two types, Adi Vyadi and Anadi Vyadi. Types of Adi Vyadi, Sara and Samanya. It is Anadi Vyadi. These are the accidentally. Okay. Panchkosha eclipse of Dhyana, same as like Ashtanga Yoga. Yeah. These are the development of Sattva Guna. All are the, you have just to remember all the names. After that, these are important. We have not studied till now. These are we had to study. Yes. Yes, not clear your voice.
Can you explain that previous slide?
Okay. Sattva Guna.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Development of Sattva Guna, there are 12 types of Pragya. Okay, means buddhi. 12 types of buddhi. Idam prathamata guna pitari samatva. Samatva means equality, quality of all the three gunas. Adham sattva, uttam madhyam adham. The lowest type of sattva, okay, lowest level of sattva. Extremely tamasic, then rajasi, rajas sattviki. After that rajas, rajasi means too much rajas, rajogona. So that rajasi tamasic, rajas sattva tamasi. In 10th, there are the mixture of rajas sattva tamasi means all three are disbalances. Okay. Tamasik and tamasattva. Idam prathamata means idam prathamata means all are starting. Can say not are so much no any dominancy, no any at low point. Okay. In first or two, second stage. Getting my voice, what I want to say.
Ma'am, is it going higher to lower level? Means, can we say this is the stages of pragya or only we can say types of pragya?
Types of pragya, not the stages.
Okay. Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, 10 number, can we explain? 10th.
Raja, Satya, Satyan, Tamasi. All three are present. Rajas, Satya, or Tamasi. Rajas, Satya, and Tamas.
Okay, I thought Raja, Satyan, Tamasi means Satya, Anta. Means here Satya. Is less only rajas and tamasi, I thought, but three gunas are there.
Ma'am, yes,
why it is the development of sattva guna, like in the at the end 12th is tamas sattva and first is edam prathamata prathamata.
Here are the I mentioned only types of pragya. If we are more study on this, like samatva, it means equality. It is the highest stage. Okay, guna pitari and adham, idham prathamata. These are the highest stages. It means there are no any dominancy or law of any sattva. Okay.
Okay.
Ma'am, can you say in samatva there is no guna?
No, guna are present, but all are in balanced state. Huh?
Okay.
But idam prathamata also they are in a state of balance, no, ma'am. There was no activity.
Yes, yes. The idam prathamata, guna pitari, samatva. These all three are the nearly the balanced state.
Then, ma'am, what about this 10th point, the Rajas, Satya, Tamasi?
Rajas, Satya, and Tamasi all are disbalanced.
Okay, all are disbalanced, and here all are balanced. Okay, okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay.
Ma'am, this one comes in question. I think they will ask the order, right? You have to maintain the order.
Mm-hmm. Here are, I don't mention in as a order.
Okay.
Yeah, I think after some time after the class, I send you photo or picture of in order wise. Okay.
So, what sort of question might appear from this, ma'am? Order only.
How many types of pragya mentioned in Yoga Shastra?
Okay, ma'am.
So no need.
Yes,
yes. Then so no need to remember the sequence.
No need to remember the sequence. That's why I did not focus on order only. Shall we move?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I will make you understand with other slide if you are feeling some problem. Okay, no problem. Next slide is there are two marga mentioned in Yogavashistha, Pravritti and Anivritti. Pravritti means one who desires heaven, the seeker or sadhaka or the person who wants to, who desire to get heaven. Okay, Nivritti means one who desires the path of salvation. Same as like in Principal Upanishad also mentioned in Katha Upanishad, Shrey and Pray. Shrey is like want to get the path of salvation, moksha. Pray is like want to get this so much richness, home, women, son. So same as like pray, pravritti, the path who is like want to or looking good. Okay, nivritti is nirvana mark. Okay, clear. So there are two marg mentioned in Yoga Shastra. After that, meaning of yoga. Yoga is a state of crossing the worldly ocean. This definition of yoga according to Yoga Shastra mentioned in Nirvana episode. Sixth prakaran, 13th sarga and 3rd sutra, shloka. Okay. This is the meaning of yoga. Yoga is the state of crossing the worldly ocean. I will share the shloka also, okay, after the class.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. After that, there are two types of solutions to merge the mind. What are the two types of solutions? Means, like in Yog Darshan, we studied two types of how can we get understand about or differentiate between Prakriti and Purush. What was the first type? Abhyas and Vairagya. Okay, so here are same as first is self knowledge and second is Prana Nirodh. Okay, self knowledge means Tattva Gyan or lack of Agyan. Okay, second is Prana Nirodh. Prana Nirodh means control on prana by the practice of pranayam. Okay, both are mentioned in Nirvana Prakaran. Okay, anyone have doubt regarding this?
No one.
The word Nivarana which is written here, ma'am, it's Nirvana, right?
Nirodha.
Okay.
Yes, Prana Nirodh is control on prana. By practicing of, we had earlier studied the mantra about mantra, self-knowledge, pranayam. Okay?
Ma'am, self-knowledge, what have you written, ma'am, previous slide? What is that nivarana? Nivarana means ajnan ko nivaran karna, ma'am.
Nivaran means
remove, ma'am?
Yes. Improving self-knowledge and lack of agyan or ending all the agyan. Okay, thank Nivaran you. Means actually solution. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, got it, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
After that, this is the story of Sukh and Raja Janak. This is the story whose moral is attainment of the highest state of bliss. Sage Sukhdev was, who is the Sukh? Sukh is the son of Vedavyas. Okay, so first question is, who is the Sukh? Sukhdev, the son of Vedavyas. Vedavyas, who is the author of Mahabharata. Okay, despite being highly knowledge, in Shuka, he constantly felt something lacking in himself. Means he is low self-confidence about his knowledge. Okay. He felt there is something is missing, and I think he's also thinking that lack of knowledge. Okay. Then Vedyas wanted to free his son from this problem on a practical level. Therefore, he asked Sukhdev to go to Mithila king Janak. Okay. When Sukhdev raised Mithila, he was not attracted towards Mithila even after seeing its magnificent towers, grand palace, women adorned with jewelry, and lush green gardens, so much richness, sparkling palace, grand palace. So Sukhdev is not attracted towards those all magnificent works of Mithila. Okay. The great gatekeepers kept him standing at the gate of palace in the hot sun for a long time. Means Sukhdev was facing problem on the standing at the front of gate of the palace. Okay, gatekeepers are keep away from this palace that you are standing at here for a long time. But he did not get angry at all. Okay, he did not get angry, nor did he feel any pain. He was just sitting near the gate. Okay, when you get time or you get any order, you can take me in. Okay, so when they got entry inside the palace, they were taken to a garden. A beautiful dance was going on there, but Sukhdev remained sitting indifferent. Okay, these showing their real knowledge, highly knowledgeable person. Then 56 types of dishes were served, but he did not praise him. But he did not praise by them. Yes, praise all the dishes. He was given a comfortable bed to sleep at night, but he slept indifferently. Means he got too much luxurious things, but he is not praise all those. After that, got up in Brahma Muhurat and started meditating. So they remained like a lotus in the water, okay, in the splendor of the palace. The next day he was introduced to King Janak. Raja Janak impressed by him. Janak touched Sukhdev's feet and made him sit on a high seat. He himself sat on the ground in front of him and said, Pramunivar, you are completely free from illusion and are highly knowledgeable person. But you are not aware of this, your tattva gyan, your knowledge. That is why you see lack within yourself. You are not aware. Means you are low self-confidence that you are, or you are not aware about your knowledge. That is why you see lack within yourself. On hearing this, Sukhdev attained enlightenment. Sukhdev attained enlightenment by only saying the words of Janak. Okay. So Sukhdev attained enlightenment, realizing one's detachment is the achievement of ultimate happiness and peace. Okay. So this is the moral of their story, Rajashuk or Sukhdev and Janak. Who is Sukhdev? Son of Vedvyas. Who is Vedvyas? The author of Mahabharata. Why Sukhdev moving Mithila Pradesh? Why? Because he is confused or lacking in the knowledge. And Vedvyas is sent him to Raja Janak, okay, for getting knowledge or getting aware about his knowledge. everyone is listening and understand what I had studied. Yes, anyone? Rajeshwari, Deepalika ji, Sakshi ma'am, Vipul ji.
What did you ask, ma'am? Whether we understood the essence of the story? Yes, ma'am, we understood.
Okay, so question can ask the story of Sukha and Rajajalaki is mentioned in which text or what's the moral of their story? Why Sukh moving the Mithila Pradesh to meet Janak? Okay. These are the questions. So is the author of Vashishtha Gita? Okay. And now?
Maharshi Valmiki, ma'am, answer already written.
Who is the author of Vashishtha Gita?
Ma'am, answer is written there.
Okay, so you all had, you will study, okay? No. Yes, yes. No problem.
Ma'am, we will do so it, ma'am. Like have doubt, how many questions so are there, ma'am?
There are only eight questions.
Ma'am, we'll take the screenshot. Yes. Ma'am, can you just show the questions, please?
Ma'am, are these questions are present in the slide?
Yes, yes. These questions are present in the slides only.
Yes, yes. Just listen, everyone.
Drive
Yes, Rajeshwari.
Okay, then we'll take it from the drive, ma'am. No worries.
Can I say something?
No, ma'am, you can say now.
Okay. Okay. So, you can all can revise one after 2 days. We can take a small a small test. Okay. Of all syllabus of Yoga Vasishtha. And okay, we'll discuss about the last year exams of Yoga Vasishtha. Past all questions of Yoga Vasishtha.
We'll be doing it on Friday, ma'am, just to prepare.
I don't know if I will free. On Friday, then definitely we will try. Or I also,
ma'am, your voice is breaking.
When we start, take a test. Maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Not after that. It will be tomorrow or day after we will take a test.